So, Arthur, is it true about the bad luck?
What bad luck?
I just broke my pocket mirror, and I remember me old ma saying that a broken mirror means 7 years bad luck.
7 years? We won't see 7 years out. Don't be ridiculous. But if I find a mirror on my adventures, I'll bring it back for you.
Thank you, Arthur.
Okay, I'll catch you later then.
Whatever you say.
Mr. Morgan!
Mr. Morgan. Mr. Pearson.
Quite a country.
Quite a country. You know, sometimes I'm glad I left the Navy.
Too many men.
Too many men. This world? Far more genteel, huh?
I never figured running in a bunch of outlaws would be the genteel option.
Well, I've seen things, sir. I've seen terrible things.
Eve!
Eat this.
We're stuck in the ship now, Mr. Morgan. In the ship. We're drowning.
Can't this wait?
Well, fine then.
My mother.
Seems quiet, Charles.
Morning, Arthur.
Yeah. Yep, here.
Now, come on.
Up.
Wait here, girl.
You made a mistake taking me, but it ain't too late. Let me go, and there's no bad blood.
No bad blood?
Deputy.
Look, them raiders blindsided me. Tied me up for some kind of ransom, I suppose. Guess that was paid, though, wasn't it? Now, come on.
There you go.
Thank you. God damn these bastards.
Get out of here before any more of them come along.
Okay. There might be some things here if you want them. Thanks again, citizen.
places like a man, you coward!
Guess I've been properly deputized.
Help,
yeah, we'd be in a heap of trouble if he'd have gotten away.
Happy to help.
The only good Braithwaite is a dead
Deputy Callahan sends his regards.
Wait, here.
This here the Gray plantation?
Yep.
Sheriff's orders. He wanted me to have a word with some folk on the property. I'm recently deputized, you see.
Deputized? And I suppose Lee was drunk when he did it? Look, you can come in, but you ain't talking with me.
Obliged.
Yep.
Hey, I was hoping you'd talk a moment. I'm a student of the history of the region, and,
I ain't the one to speak to. Try Master Bo. Think he's down there by the wood store. Boy's got all the time in the world.
Come on, girl. Come on. Huh. I'll see you at the sheriff's office.
Excuse me, friend.
We friends?
Not yet, but he is hoping.
I guess.
We don't get a lot of traveling men here, and suddenly there's a whole phalanx of mysterious but strangely helpful Yankees about the place.
Is there?
What are you doing here?
I was just looking for work.
Well, looking for something. Don't worry, your secret's safe with me.
What secret?
I got a secret of my own.
Are you secretly normal?
Excuse me?
Never mind.
The thing is, I don't care if you kill the whole lot of us and the Braithwaites.
I don't want to kill anyone.
I love her, you know.
Love who?
Penelope. But it's impossible.
Well, love tends to be complicated.
She's a Braithwaite. I'm Bo Gray, son of Tavish Gray, nephew of Lee Gray, the sheriff, grandson of old Murdo Gray. We Greys have been loyal to the state and murderous to the Braithwaites for so long now, no one can even quite explain why. Beyond blind loyalty and stupidity, I'm supposed to be loyal to some nonsense while she's amazing. She's like a woman from the future. She's like tomorrow, if tomorrow turns out fine.
Well, I'm sorry for your predicament.
Would you help?
I don't want to get involved. Gang feuds. Seems unseemly.
I'll pay. I've got money. We Greys, we've always got money. No brains mind but money.
Well, in that case...
I know she loves to sit out in the gazebo on the edge of the Braithwaite property. Take her this letter and this bracelet, please.
Oh, look out for their guards. They're worse with strangers than ours are.
Yep. Okay, girl.
Wait.
I should really appreciate you taking those to her.
Yep, yep. Let's get...
Are you Penelope Braithwaite?
Why, yes, I am.
I've got a letter for you.
Oh.
And a gift.
A letter and a gift. Well, we don't even know each other.
Well, it's not from me. It's from,
From Bo. Oh, he is so...
strange?
Yes, he's a little strange, but also so human. The rest of our families are stuck in the Dark Ages, or... well, I don't know, cave people, perhaps. Bo's different. But if they find out, they'll kill him and send me to live someplace awful, like Ohio. Have you ever been to Ohio, sir?
No.
Well, neither have I, but my uncle has a factory there. He was sort of the black sheep on account of having left. But now they tolerate him because he's a vicious snob. Families are... there's something else. You got a family, sir?
No, not really.
Well, they tolerate him because of the money. But me, with my ideas above my station, they can't stand.
That sounds pretty complicated. I don't know quite what to say.
Well, nothing to say, except I hope they all rot. I don't. Well, maybe a bit. But here, if you see Bo again, will you give this to him?
Sure.
Yep.
Yep.
Gray family business. Coming through.
You're good.
Yep. Howdy.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey, friend. Hey, mister.
Sir?
I heard that governor's trying to bring over some poor folk to cut wages.
Can't imagine things could get much worse around here, but they will.
Hey, fellas.
Hello there, mister.
Howdy, friend.